nice tonight.
The lower temperatures and the snow, it makes it awfully tempting to go out there on frozen lakes here around the tri-state.
Yeah, and while the lakes may look frozen solid, officials say don't be fooled. News4's Eric Zarnitz is showing us tonight how you can tell the difference.
When it comes to ice and water rescue, fireman Tom Stahl is an expert.
It comes up over your head.
So when it comes to walking out on a pond that's been frozen over, he has plenty of advice to pass along.
The biggest thing to think of is that there's no such thing as safe ice. All ice should be considered dangerous unless it's in an ice skating rink.
That's why Saturday he and his crew will be out on the ice training, just in case the worst happens.
When it starts to get cold, kids and people want to go outside, play in the cold weather, and that leads to them being around water, ponds that are starting to freeze over, hockey, playing out on the water, or even pets running out onto it also, the ice.
While this week has been harsh, the cold air has not been around long enough to get the ice on ponds like this thick enough for recreation. But we did find one exception.
I think it's a great idea because it's very shallow. It's not like these other ponds that can be kind of deep. So it's made specifically for this, so it's a great idea.
Beckett Park has installed a shallow pond that was ready to go last year. However, because of the warm temperatures, this is the first time it's been cold enough to allow skaters, meaning Steve can now teach his son Cameron how to skate.
That's one of the things that I would like to pass down to him is to learn how to skate and play hockey.